Hey there, I'm Dennis and I'm a developer advocate with Amazon Web Services. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can find out which user or role created an Amazon EC2 instance. If you're using AWS for any kind of non-trivial workload, you will probably have multiple users and roles inside of your account. And if you have an EC2 instance and want to know which user or role initiated its creation, you can do this in three simple steps. Step one, get the instance ID. Step two, search for RunInstances in AWS CloudTrail. And step three, find the user or role that created the instance. Please note that the built-in event history can only look back for 90 days. If you want to analyze events that happened more than 90 days ago, you need to make sure that you have an active trail in AWS CloudTrail that stores your events in Amazon S3. And I will post a link with a step-by-step walkthrough in the description below. Now, let's get started. Step one, get the instance ID. In the AWS Management Console, let's go to the EC2 dashboard. Select Instances in the menu, find the instance that we're looking for, and copy the instance ID to the clipboard, either in the list view or directly from the instance details. Step 2, search for the Run Instances event in AWS CloudTrail. With the instance ID in the clipboard, navigate to the CloudTrail dashboard. In the menu, click on Event History, choose Resource Name from the dropdown, and paste the instance ID into the search field. The Run Instances event usually is the very first event for any EC2 instance and can be found at the end of the list. Depending on the number of events since the creation of the instance, you may have to flip through some pages to get all the way to the first event. Once you've found the event, you can move on to step 3, find the user or role that created the instance. Click on Run Instances and in the details you can find the user or role name that executed the event. You can also look at the event record to get more details about the user identity and a lot of additional information in the event's JSON representation. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next one.